Hello guys. So now we finished from the first condition, which is creating HTML page. So the second condition, I have to assign the correct page structure. What do I mean by this? Is this structure will appear on the screen when I create the web page? The actual answer is no. But as we know that the web browser is working as translator. So I need to let the translator know this is HTML code. It's similar if you guys speak English and someone speaks Japanese. I need someone in the middle, which is the web browser, to work as translator between English and Japanese. And in this case, this translator asked me, please, before you ask me to translate the language from Japanese to English, please say to me, I'm speaking in Japanese. So this is the structure to start with. It's similar here. Before starting any web page, we have to put or to type the correct structure. This structure is based on some piece of HTML code that we call it tags. So HTML in general is based on tags. What does that mean? We're going to see this again in the whiteboard. So HTML, as we mentioned, is hypertext markup language. Usually this language is based on what we call it tags. These tags work as similar to the features of the thing. So if you want to use any feature, anything, you have to use the feature first and then apply what you want to apply. For example, if I want to use image, I have to use the tag of the image, which is similar to this, img with some extra functions. So let's study this tag. Every tag in HTML language started by the sign smaller than the feature itself and close it by greater than. Is it clear? So if I want to use any feature, I must start by smaller than the feature name and then greater than. So how to use this? Another point before we use this, most of these tags are opened and closed tags. We call them completed tags. If I want to use another feature which is called font, if I want to play with font features, so the feature itself is called font. As I mentioned, when I want to add any font, I have to start by the sign smaller than and close it by greater than. Here you will type the font that you want to show on the screen. And after that, I must close this tag. So how to close it? By typing the same tag, font. And before this, I have to put slash. I hope this helped a little to understand what is the meaning of tags, what is the meaning of markup language. So what about image? I'm going to image later in this, in these videos, in the coming videos. Just make sure that all tags, that when you open the tag, you must close it after using this tag, after using this feature. But after that, we're going to call it tags, not features. Okay. Is there an exception? Yes. Some tags, when we open them or when we use them once similar to image, img, we don't need to close it. All good? So you might ask yourself, what is this? What do you mean by tags? Where to put these things? So don't worry about this. Just to summarize this part, I want you to understand that HTML is based on tags. These tags are the features of the web page content. Okay. Each feature similar to this one must be opened and closed like here, with few exceptions such as images. Images, if I open this tag, no need to close it. And we're going to implement this now in the web page, okay? When it comes to web pages, Bajet, you said that there's another condition, which is the page structure. So to validate the page structure, this structure must consist of three features, three different features or three different tags. Just make sure that you put all of these three tags. So the first and the most important tag, you have to start the web page by typing HTML. So I'm going to type HTML. And when I open this tag, just remember, we have to go to the end and close this tag again, HTML. I close this tag here. Inside this tag, I have to write two tags. The first one is called head. And again, we're going to close the head. If you're still asking yourself, what does that mean? You will get more understanding when we start coding. So just now, I want you to know that we have this structure of these tags, the main thing in the web page, typing HTML tag and close it, this number one. Inside this, I have two sections. Let me call this number two, head. And after the head, we have something called body. This body also, I'm going to close the body. Is this going to be shown on the screen when I open any web page? The answer, as we said, is no. It's similar to when you say to someone, okay, I speak in Japanese, please translate to English. This is not part of the translation, but you just said, please translate to this, to make the browser knows that this is HTML code and I have to translate this. So what is this and what is that? This is the structure. When the web browser get a page, it will check two things. The first thing is the extension, is a web page extension like what we have. Now we know that we have HTML. And HTM, we have many more, but we don't use it. The second thing, is this structure exist? If yes, accept. If no, it might come with some errors. Some pages could work without part of these, but the best thing is to complete all of these tags. So please make sure that you fulfill these points, 1, 2, 3, plus saving a .htm or HTML. As we seen in Notepad++, we can use both. All good? So for this part, it's enough now to understand, as I mentioned, each HTML feature is called tag. We must open it and close it. We have three main tags in the HTML page, in the web page, which are HTML, head, and body. In the next video, we're going to implement these things or these tags in the software Notepad++, and we're going to start the exciting things. See you in the next video.